Hi, everybody. It's Lance Keltner coming to you from Austin, Texas. And today we're standing here with my pal, Sam Evans from Cardinal Instruments.
How are y'all doing?
Yeah, we are in the Sam Casa and Cardinal building facility. And we're looking at some guitars today. You want to tell us about this dog right here?
I do. This is a custom version of our Magpie model. This one has a lot of unique features. As far as woods are concerned, obviously, but I think the thing that stands out the most obviously is this Lawler Supra pickup that you introduced me to last year. It is probably one of the more special pieces of guitar gear that I've ever heard, and it seems to warrant having something built around it, and that's where the Magpie idea came in. This particular piece is a spalted sugar maple body, a solid ebony neck and a Zuricote fretboard, the wraparound tailpiece, volume and tone controls. The thing that I like most about it is the fact that this pickup is so versatile with this particular body shape, the way the neck is angled into the body. It just seems like it's a perfect fit, a marriage made in heaven, as they say.
Yeah, and tell me about these knobs. I know that you've been getting some things made recently that are very custom and one-off for Cardinal alone, and we want to know about that.
I'm glad you said that because, you know, one of our big things is regionalism. You know, how do you make guitars in Austin, Texas? If you only had materials that were within, you know, a 50-mile radius of your shop, how would you make a guitar?
Out of chips and salsa.
After chips and salsa. Wow. Okay. This is not chips and salsa, folks. Just. The hardware came, but was born of that same concept. Meaning, Michael Slotboom with Armadillo Machine Works is in my neighborhood. He's within walking distance of my shop, and I'm able to work closely with him with my ideas, and he's able to execute them almost immediately. Being small, he's very agile as far as that's concerned. Custom work, he doesn't even look at it as custom work. It's just a job. It's something that he can do. So we worked on a custom knurl for the knobs, a custom shape, and so on and so forth. Just that added little detail to kind of separate us from what's been done and what's still being done. And I think it's just that last little bit that really helps us out to differentiate ourselves.
Yeah, and what I've noticed about your guitars, Sam, is that not only are they all unique shapes, I mean, you guys have basically not done the I'm going to copy a Les Paul or a Telecaster sort of thing, which is good, but you have been innovative in the fact that not only are you using Jason's pickups, but you're also winding some of your own, which we're going to look at in a minute as well, right?
Absolutely, yes. I'm not adverse to using somebody else's pickups. I'm not adverse to other, you know, traditional body styles. I mean, I own a Telecaster. I'm very happy with it. But I feel like there's room out there for new ideas.
Right.
I'm not going to say that they're better. I'll just say that they're different. And we definitely know that it can be polarizing. You know, our headstock shape can be a deal maker or a deal breaker. You know, the fact that I do wind my own pickups. For some folks, it's like, you know, that's not going to work for me. But for a lot of folks, it's like, man, they sound great. This is that's what I'm looking for. If I wanted a Tele, I'd buy a Tele, you know. And that gives us the feeling that we are doing the right thing.
Right. And what I've noticed with, you know, having an experience of actually speccing out and buying a guitar from your shop, being like the first Magpie, which we're going to look at in a minute, by the way, is that you and your dad are both very committed to trying to do whatever the customer needs in order to build an instrument that they can use, you know?
There's no question. In fact, you know, Pop and I come from two different directions. You know, he had been a, you know, woodworker before he went on to do other things and, you know, as an engineer. And he had taught me those skills as a kid, so I'm coming back to that and using that as a player for the past almost 30 years now. And that definitely brings different ideas. You know, Pop's idea is like, well, why not? You know, and we'll execute that idea, see if it works. And back to what you're saying, it's about how to deal with customers. Him and I are both very customer oriented. Tell me what you need, and I'm going to give you a straight up yes or no answer. You know, can I do it? Yes, let's do it. If I can't, I'll send you to somebody who can. It's about the player, period.
I think that's where we can stop right now. That's a perfect way to end. And what we want to do now, though, is probably move folks over to the other side of the shop and take a look at some of the other Cardinal instruments besides the Magpie, and also my Magpie, which I really like.
It's right over there.
Just over there. So we're going to go look at that now. So we'll be right back, folks. So we're on the other side of Sam's shop now, and we're going to take a look at some of Sam's latest creations here. And Sam, let's talk about my guitar first.
Gladly. This is obviously a Magpie. Lance had come to us, as I had said before, with the idea of building a guitar around this pickup, and of course, it was a good idea, so we decided to do it. This one in particular is one that features essentially everything that Lance wanted, from the concentric pots with volume and tone, the trapeze tailpiece, the floating bridge, the banjo-style inlays, and I'm glad he did. I'm glad he went that way, because it looks great with the patina copper top, and the aged hardware, the tumbled hardware. We even did the tuner buttons to give them a bit of texture as well to work with all of this. The body woods are sinker cypress. Sinker cypress is a cypress tree that's been submerged for, in some cases, over a century. The wood is hauled up, air dried, and then sawn, and we take those blanks and turn them into bodies. It's like nothing else out there. It's a bit of a challenge to finish, but it's worth it. They tend to be a little bit heavier than the newer cypress that you might find at your lumber yard or something like that, but don't care, it's just too cool. The neck is Honduran rosewood, very rigid, a strong fundamental. The fretboard is ebony, and I like that added brightness that the ebony brings because of the softwood of the nature, the soft nature of the cypress. It's a nice match. They really work well together. 25 and a half inch scale length. I think we nailed it with the patina on the copper, each top being different. It's just a great look, and it's got it's very tactile. It feels, not only does it sound great, but it feels good in your hands. And to me, that's everything.
Well, I can attest to that. And, you know, one thing I wanted to point out here is I wanted to ask you about this, because my guitar actually almost looks Native American. It almost looks like it has, like, feathers on the top.
Well, each top is unique. And the techniques that are used to give the copper this color involve certain chemicals and heat, in this case, a blowtorch. Certain chemicals yield different colors. The heat reacts with those chemicals in different ways. And it's, as cliche as it sounds, it's a bit like a fingerprint for each one. So it's nice that people will say, hey, well, I love Lance's. I want one like Lance's. Like, no problem, but the top won't be exactly the same. And I consider that a good thing.
Yeah, I do too. I think that's great. Now, having talked about the Magpie, let's move on to this guitar here. And what is this particular one called?
This is our Zenith model. This was our the fruition of an attempt that we had to make something that was a little more familiar to folks, as far as hardware and pickups and scale length and so on and so forth. The body shape certainly has some aspects of some traditional solid body guitar design from a certain manufacturer in California, circa 1950. No names mentioned. But on this particular case, we kind of went the whole Texas wood thing and just went crazy with the Texas ebony top. Not a true ebony, but it is tight grained. It'll actually polish without any finish on it. It's amazing stuff. The back is black walnut from the Dallas area. The neck is Zerikote, as is the fretboard, a hardwood from the Yucatan Peninsula. Some folks might see Bacote as well. They're usually seen together, but they have similar tonal qualities. This one has the Spurzel locking tuners. I tend to use Spurzels almost exclusively, either the sound locks or the locking tuners. This one is 21 frets, 25 and a half inch scale length, and of course we've got custom hardware from Michael at Armadillo Machine Works with the pickup surrounds, the bridge, the knobs, and even our switch tip we have custom made. It's just a stainless steel tip. It gives the switch a nice feel. Cool. It is cool. That's a little touch. Again, it's the little things.
Well, you know, one thing that I had pointed out when I first saw this particular shape is, in a very cool way, it reminded me of the 70s BC Riches that I first saw with Aerosmith when I was a kid. And I thought, at the time, I thought that was the coolest and newest and most unique yet familiar looking body shape out there was the BC Rich Mockingbird. And although this doesn't, you know, copy that in any way, it reminds me and feels the same way. It's like I'm looking at this thing and going, this is a really cool new shape that's familiar looking and something that I would like to play. So it's really cool in that way.
Again, I appreciate that because I didn't see that originally. But when you mentioned it, you know, how these arcs intersect and so on and so forth, I had a similar reaction back in the day. I remember thinking, that's so crazy, I want one. And you have to wonder if subliminally, on some level, that was kind of influencing, you know, as I'm drawing this thing up on the drawing board, so to speak. You never know.
Yeah, it's a great shape, and it's cool. And you also do this same basic guitar with a Tele bridge pickup as well, right?
We do. As a matter of fact, that's my next point. This is custom. I mean, we had the woods laying around, and it was done for the Montreal Guitar Show. And have no regrets whatsoever. But I think what I'd like to do is we've had a lot of success using pine over the years, and we'd like to turn the Zenith more into a standalone model in the sense that it's got a pine body, maybe a maple neck, Indian rosewood board, you know, not necessarily woods that I'm going to find here and around, you know, Austin, so to speak, but certainly woods that are available and not endangered in any way.
Sure.
But it's more familiar to folks, too. And, you know, Tele bridge, Tele pickup, neck pickup, whatever you want.
Right.
But have it set up that way. Like, people recognize that. It would have a unique body construction as far as we'd probably mimic an old Tele prototype that we had actually had a chance to put our hands on that dated from about 1949.
Wow.
And just make them that way. Have Michael do the hardware and so on and so forth. And then if you need to change, we can do that. We'll work from there.
Cool.
But this certainly gives folks the idea of the body shape and the balance of the body and so on and so forth.
Right. And then down here on the end, tell us about this particular guitar. This is another Magpie style guitar, right?
Yeah. And it's the first one, the first production version after a couple of prototypes. Again, this is Sinker Cypress. And if you notice, as you can see on this one here, this one almost has a greenish tint to it, unlike yours, which is more almost bronzish or copperish in areas. And it's the mineral content in these boards. I mean, we have no control over that. You know, it's been sinking in God knows what for God knows how long. But I like the mystery. I think that's cool. I think you bring it up, it looks like it looks. Some people dig it, some people don't. We kind of took a chance on this one as far as we wanted folks to know that, look, yeah, we love this Lawler pickup, but you're not just married to this concept. You need a P90, I can do that. You want my pickups in it, I can do that.
Yeah, I mean, because I have talked to some guys since we've demoed this guitar, which is my guitar, and actually the prototype of that, which was the black one you guys may have seen before. And, you know, some people are just want to shy away from having to lay their hand on the top of that pickup. And believe me, I've played this guitar as well. And if you want a Magpie with one of Sam's pickups in the bridge or, you know, or a P90 like this one has, great guitar, and you're still going to get that sort of Sinker Cypress mojo sort of vibe on the guitar. You just won't have that particular Lawler pickup tone.
Right. In fact, this P90 is a Lawler, and I've to show that I'm not too proud, I wound a P90 and put this in here in this particular instrument. I was like, well, let me give it a shot. I like the Lawler better. It's a 50s wind, and it works perfectly with this guitar. An off-the-shelf piece. Man, I loved it. You know, I took mine out and saved it for something else, you know.
Right.
So this one's got just a standard maple neck. This is the Bacote fretboard.
Right.
Super, super figured. That we just thought, for the first one, let's make it special. And this Bacote's got a nice oil content to it, so it feels great, but it kind of mutes some of the brightness of the maple.
You know, and I guess the last question I'd really have for you is, what's coming up for Cardinal Instruments? What do you guys got on the board? Are you going to the Montreal show? Have you got new designs coming? What's happening?
We've got a few things. We're going to be going to the LA Amp Show this October, and we definitely have some custom instruments that we're going to be bringing. We're going to bring a Pine version, a production version of, if you will, of the Zenith. Maybe as many as two, just so folks can get their hands on them and kind of understand where that's coming from.
Right.
We have a couple of our original Zines, the East and the West. They'll be there as well. We've got some ideas for some carving, for the Magpie bodies.
Oh, nice.
And so that'll be a nice option we're going to have done locally. And it looks like we may be reintroducing the Formica guitars, which is going to be a big deal.
Yeah, we probably can't say a lot about that just yet, but Sam and Pop have been working with some Formica designs, and I think they're going to be very cool. I haven't laid hands on one myself, and I think the pickups are still being kind of tossed around as far as the idea.
Yeah, we're definitely in prototype phase. We have one prototype out right now with a local player. He's in Europe with it on a tour.
Kevin Carroll.
Mr. Kevin Carroll, as he prefers. There's some unique construction techniques as far as scale length is concerned, but obviously we're doing a Formica veneer and top, you know, a top and back veneer, but we're also doing an aluminum edging on the side. So
very sexy.
It's got a great look to it, and a unique scale length. Some custom hardware through Michael again, and I think the first ones will probably have my P90s in them. I think with the woods that we're using, it's probably going to be Western Red Cedar as your core. Maple neck, Indian rosewood board, nothing too fancy, just to kind of keep it simple, but to focus around that scale length, to have a unique instrument. P90s at first, probably. Single one in the bridge, and then we've got a new pickup idea that I think is going to be fantastic.
Yeah, I can't wait to see it.
I've got other work to do, but it's become a distraction lately, just trying in a good way.
Well, great. Here, just a little bit later, we're going to switch over to my Casa, and I'm going to actually play my new Magpie through my rig and kind of walk you guys through some of the tones you can get with that guitar. And in the meanwhile, I want to thank you for letting us hang out at your shop.
Thank you. I much appreciate it. It's nice to have you in here. Your interest has been certainly genuine over the years. So.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Sam and his father have done some amazing things at Cardinal, and they're... all the guitars are just getting better and better and better, and you guys need to check them out. And what's the web address?
www.cardinalinstruments.com.
Pretty simple. So you guys check Sam out and hang around for a second. We'll listen to my guitar, all right? See ya.
Bye.